My name is Silvia Gaiani, and I'm a senior researcher at Ruralia Institute, which is part of the Faculty of Agriculture and Forestry of the University of Helsinki. And actually, what I'm doing at Ruralia Institute is leading a research on food innovation and entrepreneurship towards sustainable food systems. And actually, it's a long-time research which is going to have both practical outcomes and academic outcomes. So basically, I'm going to do a research by interviewing food companies in Finland mostly, and also I'm going to conduct my research by trying to establish a sort of regional booster in South Ostrobothnia, whose main aim is going to support companies, food companies, that are really hoping and willing to become more sustainable and more innovative. And by background, I'm an agricultural economist. My research is a sort of interdisciplinary research. The main focus of it is on food and innovation, and of course sustainability plays a big role in that. Actually, I think my research is coming at a very interesting time in Finland because a number of recent policies are like supporting the development of sustainability transitions in food in the country. And actually, I'm mostly referring to Finland's food research strategy for 2035. And the aim of the strategy is to make Finland a testbed for innovation in food. And also, it's supposed to make Finland runs pilot project on innovation and sustainability. I'm trying to understand what is the current level of innovation of Finnish food companies, how innovation and sustainability can go together and can emerge, and what is, for example, the role of geographical locations and what is the role that it plays in order to promote additionally food sustainability. One of the aims of my research is to come up with new business models, new approaches to innovation and sustainability in the food system. What is really interesting about doing research about food sustainability is that sustainability refers to a desire change that we want to see in the system, and transition refers to a process of change which is always ongoing. Globally, we are now under pressure to develop a new food system. I think that when we speak about food systems, we speak about a big entity. Actually, the food system we are living in is made up of a number of subsystems. Let's think, for example, about farming system, waste management systems, and actually the big food system really interacts with additional and different systems like the energy system and the health systems, for example. So I think that by doing research on food, what I'm currently investigating is a whole universe in a way. And when we speak about sustainability, I think it really matters because the food system we are going to soon experience, the so-called sixth food system, is going to be different from what we used to experience until now. So until now, the main focus of the food system was to produce cheap food for everyone, so convenient food. The main aim was that the food had to be good looking. The main emphasis was on packaging and logistics. And actually, I would say up until now, the main focus was not really about cutting the logistics between the place of production and the place of consumption. Actually, what we are going to see right now and to experience in the future is a radical transformation, and it's actually about sustainability transitions. Alternative food systems will become more important. There will be an emphasis on short supply chains. Consumers will play a bigger role. So in the future, the food system will no longer be supply driven, but demand driven. So consumers will play a big role by putting emphasis on traceability, food safety, food security, the welfare of animals, and the welfare of their own well-being. What I really think is interesting about South Ostrobothnia, which is the test bed for my research, is the fact that food companies in the region are either really big companies, like for example Valio, Atria, Altia. They all have branches in the region. But at the same time, there are also, the majority of the food companies, they are micro food companies. So they employ between 1 and 4 people. That means that most of them are family run. And when we speak about innovation, the fact that food companies are really small can be a challenge for some of them. There are many opportunities in the region. The South Ostrobothnia was really famous for food production, so really bulk production. But now, I mean, things are slowly changing. And alongside bulk production, there are also small niche of innovation and new products and new technologies that are being developed in the region. And actually, one of the aims of my research is to promote the startups which are somehow missing. And so I'm like collaborating with a number of experts in incubation and innovation in order to understand how South Ostrobothnia can really promote innovation and can become a place where startups can not only be established, but flourish at the same time. What I'm currently doing right now is conducting interviews with the Finnish food companies. And I'm also interviewing big companies like Valio and Atria alongside really small companies, more regional ones like the small food companies based in South Ostrobothnia. And what I'm trying to find out by conducting my research is currently what are the challenges that companies face in order to promote sustainability and in order to promote innovation. And I think one of the main challenges is, for example, that people are having a hard time in understanding how to become carbon neutral. Regional and national Finnish food companies, they really have a number of questions about, for example, how to reduce waste in their daily activities, how to promote the well-being, and I mean animal well-being when they are, for example, meat and dairy food companies, and at the same time make sure that the products they produce, they are safe, transparent, easy to trace. So sustainability transition is a great opportunity, but at the same time it requires finding correct replies. What I'm trying to do with my research is also to help food companies to focus on their strength and really see what the potential is for them to become more sustainable and more innovative. I'm really trying to focus on the local strength. The regional local strength, for example, are the local food culture, the so-called sisu, which is a Finnish general attitude, and also on talkot, which is this attitude of working together for the benefit of the community. But I'm also focusing on the good existing policies on food that the region has and on the many, for example, skills of the local entrepreneurs. So by combining all these elements and by strengthening them, I think that it could be a potential good way to promote innovation and sustainability. And with my research, I would really love to make an impact, you know, and to see some changes happening in Finland and in the region of South Ostrobothnia. I would like to promote and do my little piece of work in helping food companies taking the long path to sustainability.